Thank you for inviting me. So, following the Betty's comment, I didn't change my title so much, so, but I want to be a general and somehow enjoyable talk, I try to, the last talk. So, here you see our heart of Riken Nishina Center, superconducting ring cyclotron. You can hold more than 100 people on top of it, and weigh is 8,000 tons. So as heavy as Eiffel Tower. So that's our weapon, and that is in the harvest time. So, so last month, we reached that uranium intensity of 40 particle nanoamp. And for the krypton, we reached 500 particle nanoamp. And this is safety limited, not a machine limitation. So we can go more, and this goes more. So it's okay. And then second in the world, staying here, it's a GSI. And then this situation will continue another 5 years. That's a great thing for us. And but to come here is not easy. We started the machine in 2007, and packed 1,000 to gain the uranium intensity. And many things we had to do, which was not planned originally. We have to change the ECL, so ion source, new injectors, helium gas charge stripper, and even we have to modify that cyclotron to accept a lower charge state. But, but this situation, now we come with the two stripper here and four cyclotron in cascade with drive the idea on LINAC. Okay, good. So, using this machine, this is the sketch of our experimental hole. This is a superconducting cyclotron. And the first thing is the big lips. It's an isotope separator. So, this is the best deliverer of our life for the moment. So using the uranium beam, you can cover this area. Using the xenon, you cover this area. 48 calcium, you cover this area and oxygen here, right? And the bluish place, the production cross-section have been measured. So hey, there, you can plan your experiment. You can expect how much of the beam coming per second. And then that dotted place, red load, the place you somebody did their experiment using particular beam. And then these boxes are the new isotopes we found in this machine so far. So this is a Mike Tornesen's nice compilation of the discovery of RI. And the first day, this is the Berkeley, and then GSI takeover, and then we are some rising position now. And so far we found 120 new isotopes with this machine, and only 30 are published, but we are waiting for the publication. And then so far, we did some more than, like 80 now, 80, more than 80 experiments, and RI being produced to deliver were the more than 300 species. So, good. So using this beam, we have three beam line, 0 degree samurai beam line and the high resolution line and starting from the 0 degree line. So at the end of the 0 degree line, you have your Eureka. This is used to be a Eurobowl rising project at the GSI. We invited with the help of the Walter Henning, and then this is a 200 collaboration, finally end up with the in Riken. So these are the RI we deliver to them, and more than, we did the campaign type beam time allocation, and then they approved 100 days of beam time, and they spend like 80, 90 days. So a bunch of new publications showing up. I'm not going to the detail, but one thing, which Annie mentioned, Yeah, last month, a few months ago, we published the data of 110 half-lives of new nuclides updated. Within that, 40 half-life never been measured. So that's covered somewhere here. And then the powerfulness of this is this. If you compare green curve and red curve, you fix your physics and you just update that half-life with the new data, then this changes like this. So some discrepancy is a clean up. So this is a marvelous experiment, and I think one of the good input to the R process business. And while listening, I was listening to the hard talk, I decided to put the new transparency. So, you know, we have a PETA computer in the Kobe. It's a $10 million computer, the second biggest one in the world for the moment. And by doing so, they have a big syndicate of theorists. So one of them is some collaboration from neutron merger to element genesis. And a famous cosmologist, gravitational cosmologist, he calculated a neutron merger. And then Wanajo took this data and then took abundance. And this is very impressive. So orange part is the place the uranium created. And then blue part, silver and rare earth element are synthesized. So they are doing these things somehow consequently from this person to the other person. And the most important thing is Ani said that frequency was not enough. But according to the Shibata, that luminosity, frequency of this neutron merger is a number is big enough to explain our universe. So if this is the case, then a lot of our effort might be in vain since, as Ani said, it's go far away from the present R process we are expecting. Anyway, it's a very, very good progress in the theory side. We anyway needed this kind of approach. So going to the samurai, this line, next to the zero degree color limit beam line, you have a samurai. Samurai is a superconducting analyzer for multi-particle form radioisotope beam, too long, and then it's a kinematically complete measurement by determining the multiple particle in coincidence. And we have a neutron counter even from Deutschland now. And then invariant mass measurement and missing mass measurement is a tool. And using the calcium 48 beam, they have something 10 hertz, 16 hertz of carbon 22. And then, and then also oxygen 26, they have some experiment. And first, please check this wonderful identification of each isotope. And then they found a new resonances. So it's similar to your experiment very much, but far away from the stability line. And then another subject in the samurai is for Betty. So ready for EOS. So the first day and second day, Johanna Stasche and Lassit talking about the Fogron plasma story on this. But this is not the end of the story, as we know. If you go into neutral star, you go up in the symmetry, right? That you're going to go. And then the new idea is using uranium or xenon to the isotope and combine to the very asymmetric region. That's your plan. And then it's OK. But compared to the original, that normal nuclei, your lab arm is something like a factor 2 or 3, right? So you need a new weapon, that you are detector, measuring the pion charge ratio, PN, or that helium and triton ratio altogether. I hope you can measure something really exciting to talking about. So these things that Dr. Betty talked about, I would not repeat anymore. So it's a new regime. So another new help came to Liken, the Alexander Batteri from Saclay. He proposed, we didn't his idea so much, and one day he came with a Minos detector idea. It's a state-of-art tracking device surrounding the liquid hydrogen target. So this is good for the particle hole type experiment, and we decided to combine with the DALI-2 with this machine. DALI-2 is the Motobayashi-san's invention long time ago, and that becomes famous with the front page of Nature, the discovering the magic number 34, and these two together. Another new invention we implemented a new type of propeller. With this propeller, you don't do one or two nucleus. You declare two such, two plus energy, whatever you want. So it's in a sense that with this gadget, you scan most of the thing you wanted. We got a huge pressure from the community, since people say it's not fair, but from a management point of view, we want to do it like a carpet bombing, older one, that's more effective. So we decided to go that direction with this device, and then they went two-thirds already, and, covering all the region, two plus energy. And even for the ions case, they saw two plus and four plus energy. Right. New. And then future, that device will combine with the Samurai for the new project. Good. So, yeah, Sidoni always asking me, what's happened to Nikkei 78? Sidoni disappeared? Okay, the first trial in LIBF was not scientific conclusive, but later, the systematic measurement of the lifetime with Eureka and Wasabi, the lifetime detector, we confirmed that this steep rise of this place, that the saying that the majesty of Nikkei 78 remains. And now the Minos and Dalis combination measure certainly measure. This is before the collection, it's after the collection. They know that where is the 2 plus energy of Nikkei 78. So I don't know that I'm not allowed to show the data. Okay, you can ask him. So the third beam line is this one. It's a high resolution, Shalak, we call it. And then using this one as a beam line, we have a layer radioisotope ring. So Wednesday, Uesaka-san made a nice presentation of the experiment using the Shalak. This has a very high resolution with the dispersion matching technique. And he mentioned that, tetraneutron state, they got a four event. So stay tuned. Yeah, very interesting. And using this, so I skip all the Shalak activity. And by using this, the beamline, with the gorgeous beamline, we have a layer eye ring. This one is a 24 sector cyclotron, in a sense. It's a 10 cyclotron Liken. In history, there is no RF cavity, though. It's isochronicity is the most important thing of this one. So with this one, you have to control the isochronicity at the level of 10 to the minus 6 with a momentum acceptance of 0.5%. So once the big lips get a signal to have some RI, they send a signal to kicking the RI to this ring. Oh, yeah. And then, once this is operational, you can measure mass of the R-process nuclei with a low production rate as one day, as low as one day, even the short lifetime of the 50 milliseconds. And then they are doing the alpha source testing of the revolution and the some isochronicity. And last week, they finally succeeded to get the beam. This is a single beam within the ring. This is the frequency, and this is the time. And they that single beam is showing the Schottky signal in the ring for the 4 seconds. So this is stored. So you need to work to make this line straight. But essentially, everything okay now. So congratulations to them. So another possibility, we are the forward fragmentation facility, but we have a ISOL also secretly. So we have a secret so-called at 700 MeV Leslac electron synchrotron, which is second hand coming from the company. And we combine this one together with the UCX target, which is also driven by the electron. And then with this link, you put the ion on the electron line, then this is self-combining together with the mirror potential. So you can measure that radius of these ions easily. And we are starting for the new photofission driven by the 150 MeV electron beam. So this is a Riken's first ISO beam. So tin and xenon we obtain. So we need to increase this value a bit to measure the radius, but it's a good track. So last one is a slow RI facilities I'm going to talk about. So starting this April, KEK has officially had a branch in Riken Nishina Center to have an organization to operate their special beam line, KEK KISS. This is the multi-nucleon transfer beam line to reach, let's say, tungsten 200, which normally you cannot get from the fragmentation. This is a special beam line located here. And then Paris, they are located next to the Big Lips. There you collect some alloy, which is not used for the Big Lips, and collect the gas catcher here, and then send it to the slowdown, and then laser pumping, and send it to the slow energy beam line running here. The other one, situated here, is the end of the Big Lips, and then alloy is selected by Big Lips, and then gas cell with RF carpet system slow down and collect to the user. So here you can bring your favorite gadget, multi reflection TOF or penning trap or whatever. And these are already, they are tuning for the beam for the user now. Good. So I just say something about the super heavy element. Since Morita-san missed the Monday, sorry about that, he has to go to the hospital for his maintenance. But he's okay, so no problem, don't worry, but he just skipped this conference. We are sorry about that. But the story will be the following, that he missed to show this wonderful event of 113th element, 6 alpha decay, electron capture, and 1 alpha decay more. So this will be the last element which was found by the cold fusion. So it's the last. So by observing this event, we stop this project and go to the second one. So we expect that Dubna new accelerator will start 2017. The 20 microamp of calcium 48 is expecting. And our present machine can reach 20 microamp somewhere, and then And we expect GSI new machine will come someday here. So we do the, we are tuning ourselves to do this 119 and 120 hunting this year and next year alone. And for the preparation time, we did the hot fusion test completed, and we observed the liver volume 293 and the liver volume 292 with the hot fusion. So our lesson's finished, so we are ready to go to that corner in the coming 2 years or something like that. So once this one is once challenged by the GSI, so we will repeat such experiment again. So meantime, that the people with the nuclear chemists came, and then zibogium hexacarbonyl was made, and they find it that they are in the same family with molybdenum and tungsten. That's a new piece of information they got. So now come to the general argument. Since our facility ignited all of you, you have many new projects that would go beyond our Riken-Lala idea. So here is the score. Here is our facility running. And then how to compare these things? Many things you have to consider. But for the moment, I just pick up the quoted number of 132 in each institute. So fragmentation facility, F-Lab America, Lisp, Korean, Japan, and Germany will go 100 times than our present power, 100 times. And then ISO coming, Ariel, Canada, and the dissolved spiraliton space will cover something 1,000 more. And your dream, Ulysol, and then Calif, this is China, and the reactor-based ISO facility will gain 10,000. So it's a marvelous project. We have full of them. And then we got to do something. And the Riken-Lala plan is following. We replace the first two machine, this cyclotron, with a linear accelerator, and then largely modify this cyclotron, larger one. And then we try to skip this charge stripper, and then to gain a factor 50 to 100 compared to the present. And also, this superconducting liner can be used for the super heavy element search. That are the plan. And then our beam line, this is the present facility, and then this is a place we gonna expand. And we have some future projects, and I'm not talking about today. So what will be the case in the 10 years from now? So you have a FLIP, you American continent, European continent, Asian part. You have FLIP, FAIR, LIBF, LIBF2 is operating, LISP operating, and ISO system, you have many of them. And we are designing the Ulysol and Calif. That's a wonderful situation for us. But if you ask the funding agency, their response might be different. Since if you go to another field, LHC is working 10 years afterward, FAIR is under construction maybe, and JLab is switched to the EIC, and JPAG, SpringHead, all are working. So wonderful combination all over the world, but maybe something wrong. We learned from the high energy people that your price tag reaching the $5 billion or $10 billion. Only thing you can aim is the one in the world. This is it's a partially budgetary limitation, but also the human power limitation you are facing too. And then if you sum up all the facility we are operating all over the world, it's clearly in the range of ILC. So there must be some rule operating, I wonder. So for the think about the future, rule of thumb is following. Good facility win the game, and the nuclear physics should follow one in the region type approach. Since our facility doesn't want the one in the whole world approach, it's not nice. And then limitation, we should know that limitation partially from the budget, but largely from the manpower issue. We need intelligence, many people, to do the good science. So this is a summary. So Riken RIB, harvest time, learning the world most intense RIB, and all experimental facilities are in place, many more from the world. So we are helped a lot from the world. And we keep trying to run RIBF more than 5 months per year. Also, the current situation in Japan after the tsunami and all the Fukushima accident is very tough. So please come and join. And in 10 years, most of facility go beyond RIBF will go online. So LIV will also be LIV 2, we hope. And wonderful, but we are close to hit the manpower ceiling. Probably, so need closer collaboration worldwide. So thank you very much.
Thank you for this very nice presentation and also to address some key issues for the future. We start with some questions or comments. Annie.
I'd like to start out by commending you on the decision that being one in the world is not a good idea.
I'm talking about you have only Unisol, nothing else, no good.
Yes.
So we have to be very clever to tune up ourselves worldwide.
I'm saying that's a very wise decision, actually.
It's
very nice. So I have a question about the timeline for your mass measurements act. So what's the foreseen timeline?
Year from now. Yeah, they need a tuning time, at least a year.
Are you entertaining proposals already?
No. We are following. They have a construction proposal. That is approved. That's why they are running. They got the beam time, they got the beam. So they have to have some plan to which nucleus to start or something like that. So a year from now, they will have a real physics proposal. You can join.
We have time for another question. No, otherwise, yes, Betty.
I'd like to know what's your thoughts about this limitation of manpower, because I think we probably already reached the manpower limit based on my experience of trying to find postdocs and students.
You think we have enough to keep the facilities? Even in Japan, if I'm talking only the Japanese case, I feel that the RIBF together with JPAL and the Bell is too much. That's why we invited all of them from the world, that we can continue and that we can do our best in the facility, right? So you need a help from the world. So everybody needs help from the world. So sometimes you hit the ceiling, right? So I'm talking about the budget size. If you compare the budget size, number of people, the high energy and the nuclear physics, then we are reaching closer to the some limitation. That's my feeling. And then I think if we don't have any help from abroad, our output from RIBF will be much smaller now. Yeah. Since you came, right? So we can go. That's what I'm talking about, right?
So another final question. Otherwise, we want to thank you again. And we thank all the speakers for this morning session. But then I will transfer the chairmanship because at the end of my...
Okay. Now, there will be the talk of a summary talk of Toru Motobayashi, please. After, I will... I have some information for you for the next conference.